diciamo bruciati, ancora la mano.
We've suffered burns on the hands.
Bruciati, con forti, abbiamo
skin inflammation.
Ma fortissime.
Conjunctivitis, respiratory problems.
Problemi respiratori. Non è diventato difficile, è quasi
It's become almost impossible to continue our kind of fishing.
Tipologia di pesca, perché
we've been facing this problem for 10 years now and it's getting worse every year.
Grave. Ogni anno si accentua sempre
we've reached the point
problema,
where there's a risk of a real shortage.
Non pescare niente o quasi niente.
This is Molfetta, a small seaside village in southeastern Italy on the Adriatic. Vitantonio Tedesco is a fisherman. He's been burned by mustard gas. In the Adriatic, as in many other seas, the seabed is littered with thousands of mines, bombs and other munitions lost or abandoned at the end of the two world wars. Because of the risk of explosion or release of toxic chemicals, these munitions pose a constant danger to shipping, to the population at large, to fishermen, but also to the environment and the food chain. As well as pursuing efforts to combat piracy, arms trafficking, drug trafficking and terrorism, NATO is working to reduce this threat too. That's the mission of the NATO Undersea Research Centre, known as the NURC.
The centres started off really in the 1950s by combining the efforts of several of the NATO nations to combat the growing anti-submarine threat that the nations couldn't deal with individually. From there, our work expanded in the late 1980s, early 1990s to take on mine countermeasures as well. And what we're now doing is concentrating more on oceanography and meteorology.
The precision and speed of the NURC's technology are real assets for NATO member states that wish to take advantage of it. In spring 2008, the NURC provided the Latvian Navy with better information on the status of objects lying in its territorial waters. Urgent action was needed to make shipping safer in the Baltic Sea, where there are still between 60 and 80,000 munitions dating back to the two world wars.
Since 1996, Latvian Navy participated actively in different mine cleaning operations. Their routine work is mine cleaning, but they don't possess technologies that would allow them to detect, to identify properly. And therefore, as a small nation, we could benefit from specialists, from technologies developed in NURC.
Here we are back in the Adriatic. The NURC team is conducting a location and detection mission off Molfetta. It's the result of collaboration with the Italian Navy and the port authorities.
Now we're getting to the interesting part of the operation. The vehicle is now in the rubber boat and we're ready to deploy it into the water to start its mission. The vehicle has a very sensitive sensor on it which picks up very small objects on the seabed, from the type of ordnance we're looking through, right through to detailed images of wrecks and other objects which have been dropped on the seabed. This information is then passed to other authorities, such as the Navy EOD teams, or to the hydrographic offices, where the data can be entered into navigational charts to make navigation safer for everybody.
The threat affects everyone, as most world trade involves transport by sea. Maritime safety and freedom of navigation are at the heart of NATO's original missions. So the NURC is doing everything it can to facilitate neutralization of these munitions by the member states. It's estimated that about 80% of all goods traded are shipped by sea, which means this type of work is essential for commercial reasons. But it's also vital from the food safety standpoint, as the entire fish supply chain must be constantly inspected and monitored. The undersea data gathered by the NURC will allow the area to be categorized and mapped. The job can be done by three men and the underwater vehicle. That's the strength of this technology. It's extremely effective, easy to deploy, and affordable.
In conclusion, what this technology is aiming to achieve is to reduce the cost of conducting mine warfare operations for the nations, but also more importantly to try and take more people out of harm's way by putting robots in to do the really dangerous work. And the real objective is to make this a real enabler to allow the follow-on maritime forces, be they assault forces or ships coming in to take people off a hostile coast, to make the life safer for them as well, and try and reduce the mine threat as low as we can.
And the technology is also useful to reduce the threat to the ecosystem. ISPRA, the Advanced Institute for Environmental Protection and Research, is collaborating with the NURC to study the status of the flora and fauna close to the munitions. It's been proven that chemical weapons also have a macroscopic effect, particularly in the case of chemical weapons containing mustard gas, which is an irritant that causes blisters. Our research has also identified liver and spleen lesions in fish caught in areas near the ordnance.
Di questi organismi pescati in zone in vicinanza degli ordigni.
The joint work done by the NURC and ISPRA will lead to a risk assessment model that can be adapted for other critical areas. This should reassure professional seamen, among whom the anxiety is palpable. The future of their profession and their health depends on long-term protection of coastal and marine areas. It's true that we're starting to see results, but I hope that we're going to go beyond research and investigation. We want a lasting improvement in the situation, not a palliative to shut the discontents up. We want a complete cleanup to solve this problem once and for all. Because today I'm scared, really scared.